Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is Wednesday, February 1st, and this is Hopkinton Hillers Boys Varsity Basketball on HCAM. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call, and a bit of a different home floor tonight for the Hopkinton Hillers. They are playing in the Brown Gymnasium at Hopkinton Middle School, where they will take on the Norton Lancers. This game was supposed to take place yesterday, but there was some weather in the area, some snow, and Norton did not want to risk the long trip all the way here just to have to go home. So we are here today for this TVL battle between the Norton Lancers and the Hopkinton Hillers. And due to a conflict at the high school, we are in the Brown Gymnasium, but this should be a good battle here tonight. The last time these two teams met up was back on December 22nd at Norton High School. It was a 64-61 loss for the Hopkinton Hillers, and it was certainly a heartbreaking loss as well. They led most of the game and just could not hold on. Norton ended up pulling away with the victory. So the Hillers tonight looking for some revenge, and they hope to do so here at Hopkinton Middle School. The Hillers are 5-8 on the season, and they certainly need to win this game, and of course, four more after that if they want to make the postseason. As for the Norton Lancers, well, this could be an elimination game for them. They are 3-10, and if they lose this game, they will be out of playoff contention. And they are going to introduce the starters down on the floor. So without further ado, let's send it down to the public address announcer. difficulties there, clearly, but the players, coaches, and fans having a nice laugh at it. But I think they were just barely able to make it through the national anthem. Let's recap the starters for both of these teams. We'll start off with the Norton Lancers, Brett Govan. Where's number two? He's a senior guard. Matt Peterson, a captain. Where's number 14? He's a senior forward. Jared Sicard, where's number 20? He's a junior forward. Griffin McClear is a sophomore guard wearing number 32. And Nick Ruby is a junior forward wearing number 34. And for the Hopkinton Hillers, it's number 22, Ben McKenzie, a 5'11 sophomore guard. Number 30, Jimmy Adams, one of the captains, is a 6'3 senior forward. Number 31, Austin Odell, a 6'6 senior center. And number 35, Zach Sosicki, a 6'1 junior forward. Rounding out the starting five for Tom Keene's Hopkinton Hillers is number 45, Kyle Rector, a 6'11 senior center. And he is in the center circle right now. And I mentioned Austin Odell is also a center, but they are going to put Odell at a forward position with the height of Kyle Rector. That is one thing they've been doing lately, is keeping Kyle Rector and Austin Odell together to add more of a height advantage in the low post. And at times it has really worked for the Hillers as we are underway here at Hopkinton Middle School at the Brown Gymnasium. It's Hopkinton Hillers. Boys varsity basketball is driving to the bucket and putting in the first points of the evening is Austin Odell. Right around the baseline on the left side of the key, a great feed down low as Norton works their way back up court. With possession, it's Matt Peterson, and now a kick out over to the corner as Norton will go around the perimeter. Pass to Govan on the near side. He launches the three from the left wing. That's no good. Loose ball towards the far sideline, picked up by Sosicki as the Hillers come back up court. McKenzie over to the short corner, up top, three ball, and that's going to bounce off the rim. Missed basket by Sosicki as it goes into the hands of Brett Govan for Norton, who takes it down the far side. This is a crucial game for the Hillers. 5-8 on the season. You need those 10 wins to get into the playoffs. As a long two from the right side is no good by Jared Sicard. Ball knocked out of bounds on the rebound attempt by the captain for Norton, Matt Peterson. The Norton Lancers are led by 16th season head coach Mark Liberatore, while the Hopkinton Hillers led by longtime head coach Tom Keene. Good feed over towards the baseline to Kyle Rector as he will kick it back out. Ran into trouble with a couple defenders surrounding him. And they are certainly going to have to keep an eye on the big men in the low post. Driving in, launching the shot was Adams. That's no good. Hillers recover the rebound. It's Sosicki on the left side of the perimeter. Now up to McKenzie, three ball. That's going to go rims out. And the rebound by Brett Govan. Govan takes down court, right-hand dribble over to the corner to Sicard. Now back up the sideline to Govan. Pass over to Peterson. Now Sicard, Govan, back to the captain, driving in, looking for some space in the interior, didn't find it. Went off a defender's shin, and McClear was able to recover, fortunately, for Norton. Pass back, long three, no good by Brett Govan. And the rebound is by Austin Odell. Pass over to Jimmy Adams into the lane. A kick out over to the corner. Three ball Sosicki. That's going to go rims out. Peterson with the rebound for Norton. Right-handed dribble down court. Pass over to the right short corner. And there's a long two by Jared Sicard for the first Norton basket of the evening. Ben McKenzie running into trouble trying to cross court. And Sosicki bails him out. Norton will press often in this game, I am sure, to try to draw turnovers early and often. Against this Hillers team, you want to get in their heads early on. A pass over to the baseline to Rector, and he drew contact. That's going to be a push against Matt Peterson. It'll be an inbound for the Hillers, first foul of the game by either side. On the inbound, it's Jimmy Adams. On the entry, over to McKenzie. Norton in a 2-3 zone. Pass over to Stanley, back to McKenzie. Into the interior to Stanley, back out to McKenzie. He's called for the travel. Good defense by the Lancers. Hiller's giving them a hard time working in on the interior, so the Lancers going to do the same, not leaving any open gaps there as with nowhere to go, McClear puts it out of bounds off of Adams. We'll do the inbound once again. Govan takes it down the sideline for Norton. Pass over to the corner to Sicard, back to Govan, now up top to Peterson, driving the lane, up with the right-handed hook shot, no good, and then a putback is going to draw contact. It was Ruby with the putback, and he will go to the line off the Kyle Rector foul. First foul for the Hillers. Chance for Norton to take a lead here. And there is point number three. It's now 3-2 Norton. 4 minutes, 32 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Ruby on the second attempt, no good. And then we have a foul on the rebound attempt, and that's going to be a push foul against Norton. I believe it was underneath by Sicard. Second foul for the Lancers as they have two down court with the press up the near side. Stanley now over the corner. Around the perimeter, the Hillers go. It's Justin Blanchard on that far side corner. He just recently came into the game. Driving in is Adams, over to Odell, and now to McKenzie, drives the lane and will put it in between two defenders. Nice job by McKenzie, and that's what the Hillers need to do more of. Rush that lane, work your way past the defenders, try to draw some fouls, and find some open space. They've had a lot of trouble working in on the interior throughout the season, but it is something they have recently gotten a little bit better at as McClear tries to find Govan along the sideline. It was knocked out of bounds by the defender, Ben McKenzie. Norton will inbound. Griffin McClear on the entry. Over to Govan, backcourt. 3:45 and counting left in the first quarter. Only a 4-3 game. It's been a good defensive chess match between these two teams so far tonight. Peterson in the interior, back out up top to Govan. Shot clock ran out. Nice defense by the Hillers. Hillers will inbound. Two down court to press for Norton as Stanley and McKenzie go back and forth. McKenzie rushing the lane and a good feed over to the baseline. Rector up for the shot. He is rejected. Loose ball is picked up by Norton. It was McClear on the far side picking up the loose ball. Jared Sicard not afraid of the low post going up against Kyle Rector there. And that was a great block by Sicard, who now has the ball, drives in, pass over to the corner to Peterson. Pass two defenders into the paint, over to the corner, a long two no good by Collimore, and the Hillers have it back as McKenzie comes up the near side. McKenzie, top of the perimeter now over to Adams, back to McKenzie. Around the defender, kicks it out over to the left side to Stanley, now back into Rector. Now over to the right wing, and there's a three attempt by Blanchard, no good, put back is no good. And then the ball is going to be knocked loose by a Lancer and picked up by a Lancer. Norton takes it back up court. 2:25 and ticking left to go in the first quarter as Brett Govan calls it out. Over to Matt Peterson, the captain. Back to Govan. Now Peterson driving in over to the corner. Trying to take it up the baseline is Sicard. Kick up to Govan, three ball. That's off the iron, no good. And it's recovered by the Hillers as Nick Stanley has it. Over to McKenzie it goes, off a defender. McKenzie rushing the lane with the jumper. That's no good. Able to grab the loose ball, his own rebound, but tossed it over to Govan as he was trying to get rid of it quickly with a defender right in his face. But then a quick pass up court to try to get Collimore open in the lane. Ends up out of bounds, so no harm done for the Hillers as they will inbound with 1:48 left. Only three field goals between these two teams combined in this first quarter so far. Sisitsky over to Stanley. Stanley back to Sisitsky. Now Stanley Kick it over to Adams into the corner. Three ball Blanchard. That's going to go off the rim. Rector with the rebound. Pass to the short corner. Jumper no good by Sisitsky. And then the attempted save by Blanchard is denied as it went out of bounds. The Lancers have it. 1:23 left in the first quarter as Sam Baker will come up court. Up top to Sicard, looking in on the interior. Pass back to Collimore towards the right wing. And now it's Govan. Into the paint, wide open. Turnaround jumper by Baker from the left block is no good. And then it was knocked out of bounds on the rebound attempt by Collimore. And that was a huge opportunity there for Norton. That is a shot you have to make. You're wide open at the baseline. You have to make that. Sisitsky over to Stanley. Back to Sisitsky. Now Stanley, who will call it out. Trying to shift the players around in the interior and shake up these defenders. Stanley feeds it into the paint to Sisitsky. Pass over the left wing. Three ball by Blanchard. That's no good. And the rebound, the putback. Yes, Zach Sisitsky with his first field goal of the game. And we'll get a timeout. 36 seconds left to go in the first quarter. It's a 6-3 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers over the Norton Lancers. Despite the fact we are in the Brown Gymnasium this evening, this is Hopkinton Hillers High School varsity basketball on HCAM. Let's take a look at the scoring totals so far in this game with 36 seconds left in the first quarter. Ben McKenzie, Austin O'Dell, Zach Sisitsky have all connected for two for the Hillers. As for Norton, Jared Sicard with the only field goal, and Nick Ruby went 1-for-2 from the line to give the Lancers that third point. This has been an aggressive defensive game between these two teams, seeing a lot of tough physical play, and I'm sure the Hillers, they are badly trying to get revenge for that loss early in the season against Norton. It was a 64-61 last second loss by the Hillers. And you could see that they really want this one bad as they are trying to force turnovers and playing some physical basketball, which they'll certainly need to do. Hillers have struggled offensively, so they are going to have to dominate on the defensive side of the ball for the rest of the season as Govan comes down the far side. Pass up top, driving the lane. Baker underneath to Collimore. He is rejected by Blanchard as he went up for the lay-in. Hillers have the turnover. Up top for Hopkinton is Stanley. 13 seconds left. Over to Rector. It's ripped away as Norton gets it back. Baker takes it down and now into the corner. Attempted pass over the elbow is going to be denied. And then up top, the last second shot, no good. After one quarter of play, it's Hopkinton 6, Norton 3. Second quarter coming up next on HCAM. We are ready for the second quarter. It's Hopkinton Hillers boys varsity basketball on HCAM. And we are at the Brown Gymnasium at Hopkinton Middle School for this one. This game's supposed to take place last night. They moved it to tonight due to some snow in the area. There was a conflict at the High School Athletic Center. So here we are, where Hopkinton High School basketball used to be hosted. In the Brown Gymnasium as Govan gets it over to Kearsley towards the left wing. Now back to Govan on the left side of the perimeter as Norton will go around the dial trying to shake up these defenders. Attempted pass inside is ripped down by O'Dell. Great steal there. Now over to McKenzie, who comes up the sideline. McKenzie calls it out, gets it over to Adams on the right side. Back to McKenzie now. Now it's Adams, right side of the perimeter. He'll fire it across with a skip pass to Blanchard. And as Blanchard came down with it, some contact. And I believe they got Kearsley with that one. As he was trying to rip that pass away from Blanchard, the Hillers have the inbound. It's the second foul for Norton. Kelly to the corner to Blanchard. The defender all over him. Surprised there was no call there, but it's stolen away by Baker as the defense by Kearsley pays off for the Lancers. They go around the perimeter, having a hard time getting into the interior. Three ball there by Baker. That's going to fall out. Hillers have it back. McKenzie rushing the lane, pass a couple defenders up with the right-handed shot. That's no good, ripped down by Kearsley. Here comes the Lancers, over to the left wing, driving in. Long two from the left side by Sicard is no good. Hillers have it back. Well, the big flaw with Hopkinton this season is they're a good defensive team, as we have a foul over on the far side. That one is gonna be against Sam Baker. That's the Lancers' third. The Hillers are a good defensive team. They can own the low post in almost any game, but their big problem this season has been shooting. They have struggled from the floor a lot of games this season, and they are trying to fix that problem. As they are trying to shake up these Lancers' interior defenders, McKenzie drives the right side of the box, and then a pass in the interior to Rector at the baseline, and as he went up for the shot, drew some contact. A hold is called there, and that is another one on Kearsley. So Rector at the line for a couple of free throws. First one is good. I understand Kearsley wants to be aggressive with the big guys on the Hillers, but can't be grabbing them like that. You're going to rack up the fouls and give them opportunities from the line. Second free throw, no good. It is a Norton rebound, as there to collect was Collimore. Taking it down court, Sam Baker, he'll call it out. 6:23 and ticking left in the second quarter. Over to the corner. Now into the interior, back out to Baker. I think Norton just needs to rush the lane at some point here and hope for a foul. An attempted pass over to Kearsley, stolen away by Blanchard. He'll come up the sideline. Blanchard to McKenzie. McKenzie looking in on the interior, calling it out. Signaling for Kelly to work his way in. As they go around the perimeter, it's Blanchard on the left side. And now over to Rector at the elbow. An attempted pass over to the baseline to Odell is going to end up out of bounds. Off the Hillers. A little too much mustard on that pass. Norton will have it. 5:46 left to go in the second quarter. It's a 7-3 Hillers lead over the Norton Lancers as they press, trying to force the turnover. And that was a close call for Coach Keen as Matt Goodman of the Norton Lancers went flying into him, trying to save that ball from going out of bounds. It is certainly tight confines here at the Brown Gymnasium, especially along those sidelines with both of the team's benches. Over the baseline and the easy lay-in by Kyle Rector. Up with the left hand, he went off the glass. That was perfection. And I think that's what the Hillers need to do as they send four up court to press. Big opportunity here for Lancers. Great pass down the sideline to Kearsley, who feeds Nick Ruby, and Ruby gets revenge. Off the glass he goes, and now Hopkinton back in their offensive zone. McKenzie up top, pass over to the right side to Kelly. Into the short corner, back to McKenzie. Blanchard looking for it. He has it now on the left wing, over to Odell on the elbow. Now back out to Kelly, driving in, over to McKenzie. And as McKenzie went to retrieve that pass, some contact with Sam Baker. That's going to be the fifth Lancers foul of the evening. 4 minutes, 50 seconds left in the second quarter. Hopkinton 9, Norton 5. Inbound for Brendan Kelly. To center court he goes to McKenzie. Now it's back over to Sisitsky driving in. Good pass into the paint to Odell. Baseline jumper, Rector, and one. Second field goal of the evening for Kyle Rector. And that is the sixth foul for Norton. We still have a good amount of time left here, so Norton better watch out. I believe it was Sam Baker who got that foul. And if I'm correct, that would be his third. The and one is good. Kyle Rector having a pretty good night so far, 6 points. Four up court to press once again. Almost poked out there by the quick hands of Brendan Kelly, but Goodman ends up with it as Norton is able to work their way into the offensive zone. Goodman drives in, launches the long two from up top. That's no good. And then the big man Rector able to pull it down is coming up the near side is Sisitsky as they'll go around the perimeter. Pass to the corner, three ball. That's no good by Kelly. The putback attempt by Odell off the glass. Yes. Austin Odell with his second field goal. Four up court once again on the press as Goodman comes down. Over to Ruby on the right side. Back to Goodman, now Ruby, surrounded by defenders. Goodman looking up top towards Govan. Govan now over to Kearsley, into the paint to Peterson, driving past two defenders. Up with the right-handed layup, yes, and the contact. And let's see if they give that to him. And they will, so it is an and one. Well, that was pretty good. You got two big defenders around you, but you just drive right between them, put it up and in with the foul. Can't beat that for the Lancers. Matt Peterson on the end one, no good off the front of the rim. Austin Odell on the rebound as the Hillers work their way back up court. McKenzie over to Sisitsky on the right side of the perimeter. Sisitsky calls it out, back to McKenzie. McKenzie now to Sisitsky. Pump fake, pass over to Kelly on the left wing. Kelly looking in towards the corner, back up to McKenzie. McKenzie drives in, thought about the deep two, but a good feed into the paint. Up for the shot is Adams, and there's a foul. Some contact there on the attempted block. And that one is going to be against Matt Peterson. That's his second. Jimmy Adams at the line. Misses the first. Hopkinton 14, Norton 7, 3 minutes, 19 seconds left in the second quarter. As Norton makes a couple substitutions. Brought Matt Goodman back into the game. Second free throw, got it. And that has also been trouble for the Hillers, making free throws, but they have certainly gotten a lot better at free throws as the season has moved on. Peterson over to the short corner, long two, that's no good, air ball by Goodman, and then on the putback attempt we have contact. That one is going to be against Adams. This will be a Lancers inbound. Goodman on the entry. Over to Ruby, nearly overthrew him. Up top now to Govan. Good ball distribution over the short corner and then to the free throw line of Ruby, but is not able to capitalize, and the Hillers have the turnover. Brendan Kelly inbounds to Stanley. Back to Kelly. Attempted pass into the offensive zone, and it's batted in the air by Goodman and stolen away. Lancers now trying to find some points here. Three ball up top, that's no good by Goodman. Hiller's rebound as Rector was there. Now to Sisitsky, driving the lane up with the left hand, no good. No foul called, surprisingly, as the defender Goodman fell to the ground, and then the ball knocked out of bounds on the attempt by Govan, who worked the sideline, but the Hillers playing some good transitional defense here, and they have forced a couple of turnovers after they themselves turned it over. And we're going to have an offensive foul here. A hold over towards the baseline, and Norton will have it. I believe that was on Adams. As the Lancers back down court. And I've been corrected, it was on Justin Blanchard, that foul. As the Lancers go around the dial into the corner, it's Ruby. Now back up top to Govan. 1:58 and counting over to Govan, stolen away by Rector. Quick break up court by Sisitsky. Around the defender, turnaround jumper, yes. Zach Sisitsky making it happen. Nice advance up the left side of the key. Munger to Govan. Kick out to the corner. It's Peterson driving in. Around two defenders. The feed to the right block. And now back to Peterson. Up for the shot. That's no good. Rector pulls it down. 127 and ticking here in the second quarter. Pass to Adams, and as he drives the baseline, he's going to be called for the travel. Norton will inbound. Hillers send one up court. Hopkinton 17, Norton 7, 122 and ticking left to go in the second quarter. Brett Govan comes down the sideline. Over the corner, driving in, deep two, no good. And the Hillers come away with it. It was Sicard on the attempt. With the rebound, it's Adams. And Adams is contested by the defender, McClear, and nearly lost it there. And will have a foul call. And that is going to be a hold against Blanchard. The Lancers will have it. That's his second. Tim Munger on the entry to Govan. Govan calls it out. Over to Sicard, back to Govan, now to Munger. Govan to Munger, three ball, and it's no good. Wide to the left. McKenzie there for the rebound, coming up the near side. Top of the perimeter. Kick out to Stanley, and now an attempt to get it to Rector down low is denied. Pass a little bit too far in front of him. Peterson has it, and now a two attempt there from the left side of the paint by McClear is no good. Hillers get it right back. Lancers just having all sorts of problems offensively in this first half. McKenzie over to Stanley. Now good kick out there by Odell. Back to Odell on the give and go. And he'll take it to the rack and put it in. Govan works the sideline as he comes down. He's going to launch a deep three here, and it is going to be no good. It is going to be a Peterson rebound. Blanchard got wrapped up with him, and the possession arrow is going to be in favor of the Hillers. 2 seconds left in the first half, so we'll have a pass and shoot here. Long pass stolen away, and it's shot the other way, and it's in! Wow, Matt Peterson hitting the three. That is certainly a play of the week, a play of the month, maybe even a play of the year. That was incredible. Stole the pass and just tucked it right into the basket for 3 points. Maybe that's the momentum boost the Norton Lancers need heading into the halftime locker room. Well, after one half of play, it's the Hopkinton Hillers 19, the Norton Lancers 10. We have ourselves a close one here as we head into the second half. This is Hopkinton Hillers boys varsity basketball on HCAM. Second half up next. Welcome back to Brown Gymnasium here at Hopkinton Middle School. It's Hopkinton boys varsity basketball on HCAM. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call as we are set for the second half. It is a 19-10 Hopkinton lead over Norton. And for those of you wondering why we are at the Brown Gymnasium, it is because it was a conflict with the makeup date of this game at the high school. So something else going on in the high school athletic center. So we'll play it in the gymnasium that Hopkinton High School used to play in. Well, the Hillers started shooting well in that second quarter. They put up 13 points. And that is a lot better compared to the 6 they put up in the first. And they are also doing a nice job at forcing turnovers. We'll see if the Lancers can get back into it offensively, as they really struggled all second quarter long. A pass over to the left side of the paint, and that is going to be another missed opportunity by Nick Ruby, but then the ball mishandled by Rector, and it ends up out of bounds, so the Lancers will have it right back. Well, that's what you can't do if you're Hopkinton. You don't want to give the Lancers more opportunities to get their offense going. Because at times they can get it going. Will they tonight? We shall see. We'll get you the scoring totals for both teams in just a moment, as driving in on that one is Peterson, the captain. That's no good. The Hillers will work it back down the sideline. Long pass by McKenzie over to Adams. Now into the paint. as it is going to be Odell getting wrapped up with Sicard. And Hopkinton will inbound. Let's take a look at scoring totals. We'll start off with Norton. Matt Peterson with 5 points. Jarrett Sicard with 2. Nick Ruby with 3. For the Hopkinton Hillers, it's Ben McKenzie with 2. Jimmy Adams with 1. Austin Odell with 6. Zach Sosicki with 4. And Kyle Rector with 6 for the Hopkinton Hillers. As Adams back to McKenzie. Now back to Adams on the left side. Driving in. Kicks it over to Sosicki on the right wing. Turnaround jumper, air ball, no good. Pulled down by Sicard. Lancers will take it back up court. It is Govan up the near sideline. Just underway here in the third quarter. Just over a minute in. No field goals for either side yet in this quarter. Sicard drives in and an attempt to get it back out to Govan, and that's going to be backcourt violation. Aaron pass there. Govan not in the place the card thought, and the Hillers have it. Well, it was a pretty amazing shot to end the first half, for those of you that missed it. Matt Peterson for Norton intercepted an inbound for the Hillers, and then hooked it at the hoop, went off the glass and in for Norton. So a little momentum there. An attempted pass by Sicard was tipped by Rector. The Lancers were able to hold on to it, but then Peterson trying to gather it up ended up backcourt, so the Hillers have it back. Adams will inbound. Jimmy Adams with the lone free throw so far tonight. To Nick Stanley it goes. Over to Adams, back to Stanley. Adams driving in. There's Stanley up top. Now to Adams, 3-ball. And that is going to be wide to the left. Norton has it back. Well, it has really been back and forth defensive game here. As Tim Munger, a wide open opportunity from towards the right wing, swishes it through. Can't leave a shooter that wide open along the perimeter. It often doesn't go well. Over to the left side of Blanchard. He launches the three. That's going to go rims out. Rector there for the loose ball. Pass up top to Stanley after it went off the hands of Munger. Hillers trying to shake up the interior. Adams drives in and now finds Odell coming down the lane, up with the right hand, no good. And it's pulled down by Peterson as the Lancers take it back up court. Munger back to Peterson. Now to Munger, going to try it again. And just wide to the right there. Rector pulls down the board and distributes it to Stanley, who takes it across. Over to Adams on the corner. Back to Stanley, now Adams. Driving baseline, and he stepped out of bounds. Oh no, actually that's a foul. That one going to be on Peterson. That's his third. Hiller is on the entry. Up top to Stanley. Back over to Adams, now Stanley driving in. Feeds Adams. Skip pass over to Blanchard, and he lost his dribble, surrounded by defenders with that Norton zone D. Ruby got a piece of the ball, and then Munger wrapped him up for the jump ball. It will go Lancers' way. Munger on the entry. 4 minutes, 57 seconds left in the third quarter. Hopkinton 19, Norton 13. As the Hillers make a substitution, Blanchard back into the game. Top to Govan, now back to Munger, driving a lane and going up for the shot, denied. Can't get past those big men, but it's stolen right back on the errant pass. A long two from McClear, that's no good. And the Hillers will take it right back into the offensive zone. McKenzie in the corner, up top over to Stanley, underneath to Rector, and now to Odell, who's coming down the lane, and an easy bucket there. For Austin Odell, he has just owned the paint in this game, doing a nice job at finding open paths down the lane, and there's been a number of those with Odell just coming down the lane, getting the pass and taking it right to the hoop. Goodman missed that shot, and then a pair gets wrapped up towards midcourt. We're going to have a foul, and that's going to be contact against McKenzie. Lancers will have the inbound as they will substitute Jared Sicard back into the game. 4:01 and counting left to go in the third quarter. Both teams with a lone field goal in this third quarter. Munger for three, no good from the corner. And with the loose ball is McKenzie. Over to Stanley, around the defender, up from the right block, and one. That one against Matt Goodman. That bucket put the Hillers up by 10, and now to try to make it 11. As the gym goes quiet, he's got it. 24-13, Hillers leading Norton. Up court is Govan, who will take it across the middle. To Goodman, back to Govan. Now Goodman driving in from the wing, up for the shot. All kinds of contact there from Blanchard. That's his third. Matt Goodman to the line and in foul trouble. Blanchard will talk to Coach Keene. First of two is no good. Well, the foul doesn't mean much if you can't capitalize on it and hit the free throws. And with the lack of offense this game, Norton could really use some free throws, and they get one there. Back into the game for the Lancers is McKinley Kearsley. Hillers on the inbound. 3:32 and ticking, a 10-point lead for Hopkinton, 24-14. Here in the third quarter, McKenzie finds Odell to the left of the paint. Turnaround, up with the right hand, no good. Loose ball is collected by Kearsley, and the Lancers have it back. Went off the hand of Blanchard. Thought he was going to pull it in, but just could not get a grip on it. Kearsley on the wing, up to Govan. Now over to Munger. Back to Kearsley. At the elbow, pass to the corner, driving baseline. Trying to go up between two defenders is Sicard. That's going to be Hiller's ball. He stepped out of bounds. Nice attempt, but he had a wall of defenders in front of him between Rector and Blanchard. McKenzie comes down for Hopkinton. Pass to Stanley, now McKenzie. Around the horn they go. McKenzie drives the lane, up for the shot, no good, and then it's pushed out back towards Kelly. It was pushed out by a Lancer, and then now stolen away by Munger, who's there to intercept the attempted pass, and then it'll be Kearsley going coast to coast, drawing the foul. So another free throw shooter for the Lancers. As the officials will talk things over here. And they're gonna say it was a push foul. Kearsley on the first, no good. Second attempt, got it. So he splits the two. 24-15, 2:27 and ticking left in the third. McKenzie down court for Hopkinton. Looking in on the interior, pass over to Stanley. Back up to Rector, and now over to Blanchard, who, as he went up for the shot, drew the foul, and a push foul on Sicard. Drew the foul just before the shot. Hillers will inbound. Rector on the entry to Blanchard. Now up top to McKenzie. McKenzie taking it in. Kick out, and the three ball is no good by Kelly. The Lancers have it back. Well, none of these teams have been able to deliver the knockout blows offensively yet, as Munger going to try to knock down a three, and he swishes it through. Big momentum boost there for the Lancers. 24-18, and Hopkinton is slowly but surely losing their lead as McKenzie drives the lane, and he'll go off the glass and in for that one. And that is a well-needed bucket by Hopkinton. They need to be aggressive and drive the lane. The outside shooting is not working for him at all. Munger for three. Wide to the left that time, but it's a rebound for Kearsley. Up top to Sicard. A couple defenders around him trying to feed the elbow, and a good job by McKenzie getting that one away. And we are going to have a push foul against the Lancers. And Hopkinton will inbound. Official going to check the court, see if we need to get a, they need to get a towel out there. 26-18, 102 left in the third quarter, and I think we're going to have an official's timeout here to wet the court. Maybe not. Adams on the entry. With defenders all over the place, he's able to put it right in the chest of Sosicki for that one. Great pass there. We've got the defensive pressure. Norton clearly in a man trying to grab the turnover, but it doesn't pay off. And now Sosicki driving baseline. Good path to the basket, draws the push. At the line, 4-2. First of two, no good. Well, Hopkinton really had an opportunity in this quarter to run away with this thing, but they have not been able to get much going offensively. Second free throw attempt. Got it. 5 points tonight for Zach Sosicki. Coming up court for the Lancers, Matt Goodman. Over to Munger, who thought about the three. Out of the corner to Callimore, and that's why they got Munger out there for those three-point buckets. Sometimes it can get red hot. Around the defender, it looks like he kind of passed that one to himself, but the shot is no good as McKenzie grabbed the rebound. We have a push. That one's going to be underneath by Callimore. It's his second. 23 seconds left in the third quarter. We're going to have a timeout as the Hopkinton Hillers leading Norton 27-18 with 23 seconds left in the third quarter. Let's take a look at the scoring totals. We'll start off with the Norton Lancers. Tim Munger with 6 points so far. Matt Goodman with one. Matt Peterson with five. Jared Sicard with two. McKinley Kearsley with one. And Nick Ruby with three. For the Hopkinton Hillers, it's Nick Stanley with three, Ben McKenzie with four, Jimmy Adams with one, Austin O'Dell with eight, Zach Sosicki with five, and Kyle Rector with six. Offense has been tough to come by for both teams in this game. And the question is, what team is going to get hot first? Because this game still very close, and plenty of time left. Norton started cutting in that Hillers lead to start out the third quarter as Hopkinton just wasn't hitting anything from the floor. But then McKenzie seemed to change the momentum a little bit when he found a path right down the lane. And then Sosicki drew a great foul driving baseline as he takes it down court now. Over to Stanley. 13 seconds and counting left in the third quarter to Rector, and Rector could not hold on to that pass. Try to pull it in, but lost possession of it. Lancers have the turnover. Norton has certainly been winning the turnover battle tonight, but they just have not been able to take advantage of it. Goodman waits to pick that one up to reserve time. Top of the perimeter, driving in, buzzer beater, yes. Matt Goodman with the second Norton Lancers buzzer beater of the night. Fadeaway jumper gives the Lancers 10 points in the quarter. And as we head to the final 8 minutes of regulation, it's Hopkinton 27, Norton 20. This is Hiller's Boys Varsity Basketball on HCAN. Welcome back to the Brown Gymnasium at Hopkinton Middle School. Tonight's home for the Hopkinton High School Boys Varsity Basketball Team. As we enter the fourth quarter, it's the Hillers 27, Norton 20. Jimmy Adams on the entry from the near side. The Hillers need to get something going offensively because the Lancers, they were certainly thinking comeback as their offense started getting hot towards the end of the third quarter. Driving in, Adams, pass over to Rector on the short corner, now underneath. Baseline reverse by Adams, and he goes off the glass and in. That is a great field goal there for the Hillers. And some nice skills on display by Adams. There's a jumper from the short corner, is no good by McClear, and the Hillers have it back. At the right wing, driving in is Stanley, and now they'll go around the perimeter. Stanley looking in on the interior. Hopkinton trying to get in position. Rector on the right wing, now into Odell. And a pass to the driving Sisitsky, goes up from the left block, draws the contact. Lancers fans not happy about that push call. Sisitsky at the line for two. He has 5 points, 1 for 2 from the charity strike. Make it 2 for 3. It's once again a 10-point lead for the Hillers. Chance to make it 11 here. No good. Off the iron, and the Lancers have it as Munger pulls it down. Goodman up the middle. Three ball by Goodman off the glass, and yes. That is what the Lancers need to get the momentum in their favor. Adams to Odell, and now it's up top to Stanley. He drives in, now takes it back out. Stanley signals, pass backcourt to Sisitsky in the center circle, and now Rector. Odell back to Sisitsky, driving in, up from the left block, there's a foul. Griffin McClear again, his second. Well, McClear kind of put his hand down firmly, so that's what drew the call. And the little contact there as Sisitsky hits the first of two. Would have been a good block, though. Second for Sisitsky, yes. 2 for 2 that time. Well-needed free throws for the Hillers. It's now a 9-point game once again. Goodman on the wing, now back to Munger, now back to Goodman. Munger on the corner, now to Peterson. Goodman. There's Peterson, and into the interior, two defenders in front though. Feed back to Peterson, over to the left wing, three ball falls out. Munger on the attempt, now stolen away nearly, as it was knocked out of the hands of Kyle Rector. Didn't notice that Collimore was right behind him, but then we have a foul on the steal attempt by the Lancers. Push foul called, and this is going to be a 1-1 for Hopkinton. Hiller is in the bonus. Nick Stanley on the front end of the 1-1. Off the front of the rim, no good. Lancers have it. No harm done there for Norton. Peterson to Goodman as he will take it up court uncontested. Hiller's concentrating on the interior. They don't want to leave anybody open. Good ball distribution, but there it's stolen away as Munger tried to get it back to the top of the perimeter. Great read by McKenzie as he takes it coast to coast, but misses the right-handed layup, and Peterson pulls it down for Norton. That would have been certainly a great job by McKenzie if he was able to get the points there as Goodman launches it from the free throw line. No good. Hillers have it back. Stanley to McKenzie. 5-11 and counting left to go in the fourth quarter. Towards the sideline, it's Adams. Pass to McKenzie at the block, up for the shot, no good. And the loose ball gathered up by Sicard. Lancers quickly take it back up court. McClear up the sideline, into the paint. Kick out to the left wing, wide open three, and it falls out. Therefore, the rebound is Blanchard. Pass to Stanley, who will take it down the sideline. Back to McKenzie. Now Stanley along the far side. Over the corner to Blanchard. And we are going to get a timeout by Coach Keene. He wants to talk things over. 4 minutes, 40 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. It's Hopkinton 32, Norton 23. The Hillers desperately need to get this victory if they want any hope of going to the postseason. 5-8 overall, pretty tough road ahead. And they are certainly going to have to beat these teams below them in the standings. Lancers 3-10, they are facing an elimination game here. If they lose this one, they are out of playoff contention. But certainly some good young players on this Lancers team. And we've gotten a look at a few of them. McKinley Kearsley, an impressive player. I'll be looking out for him in the next couple years going forward. And then also Jared Sicard as well. A pretty good player for the Norton Lancers. As for the Hopkinton Hillers, they're great defensively. They're great in the low post. They're great at winning the rebound battle, but they just have not been great shooting-wise, and that has been their downfall throughout this season. And they had a good stretch for a while where they won three straight before a tough loss in their last game. But they need to get the shooting going as Adams inbounds to Blanchard. Hillers hoping to put this game away as quick as they can here. Good feed inside by Adams to Odell, who draws contact. And that one is going to be against Sicard. So this is going to be a double bonus here as Adele misses the first. Second free throw attempt. No, falls out, knocked out of bounds by the Hillers as there's Adams trying to gather it up, ended up knocking it out. Hopkinton's gonna press. 4:29 left, time to put the pressure on, hold on to that 9-point lead. Matt Goodman up the near side, and he was attempting a pass there, went off of Adams. Lancers to inbound. Munger over to Goodman. We'll go around the horn. Govin launches a deep three and he hits. Nothing but net. Lancers are not going anywhere. Hopkinton better score some points here. The Lancers could work their way back into this one. Up top, Adams driving in. Ball knocked away, but he regathers. And then out of bounds it goes off the hand of Goodman. Some good aggressive defense there. Well, Hopkinton had a nice win streak going where which started on January 17th. They defeated Westwood 43-40. That was a huge win against a very good Westwood team. And then took down Ashland and Dover Sherborne. But the winning streak was snapped when they met up with Medfield, as we have another Norton foul here, and Brendan Kelly going to the line. 4-2, double bonus. And that's been a problem for the Lancers too. They've been a little bit too aggressive, getting into foul trouble early on. As Kelly hits. When you're playing a team like the Hillers who have trouble shooting wise, you don't want to give them these freebies from the line. Make them score from the floor as the second free throw goes through. Two on the press, now three. Tossed up the sideline, out of bounds it goes, but it was off the hand of Rector, I believe. And the official confirms that. Coming up next for the Hillers, they got Holliston at Holliston. That's gonna be a tough one. Holliston's having a great year. Holliston already beat the Hillers once this season. Then you got Bellingham, Medway, and Westwood. So the schedule does not get easy for the Hillers. Long three there, no good, but gathered up at the baseline. The putback by Sicard is no good off the side of the rim. And you could have mistaken that one for a pass, but Norton unable to take advantage. McKenzie driving in as he will take it up the lane and look for the shot there. Ball knocked out of bounds by Govin. It will be a Hopkinton inbound, and McKenzie thought he was going to get some free throws. 3:08 left in regulation, 34-26. Hopkinton leading Norton. This one not even close to over. Only an 8-point game as Sosicki up to McKenzie. Now back to Sosicki. Over to Blanchard. Into the paint to the driving McKenzie, and he is going to draw the elbow from Brett Govin. Ben McKenzie at the line for his first time tonight. First of two, no. Second opportunity, yes. 5 points on the night for Ben McKenzie, as the Lancers will substitute here. They'll bring in Sam Baker. Baker on the entry to Munger. Full court pressure. They got four down court. Now Munger, pass over to the short corner by Ruby. Now to Sicard, into the paint. Back to Ruby on the shot. That's no good. Hillers have it back. Hopkinton is not afraid to press four, and that's part of Coach Keene's game plan, is a quick moving defense. You press them all, and then you have to rush back to get on your side. And that's why he makes his players run a whole lot in the practices, as this one's stolen away off an attempted pass by Sosicki from the corner. The Lancers have it back. Munger up top to Baker now. Munger on the left side. Baker running point. Attempt to get it into the interior from the corner is denied and ripped away by Blanchard. Hillers steal it right back. 1:55 and ticking. McKenzie, good feed underneath to Blanchard. Missed the opportunity, but the putback, yes. They will get the points there and go back up by 11. Nice feed over to the right block, but denied by Odell. Hillers have it back, great block there. Sosicki with possession. McKenzie trying to set the screen, and we are going to have a timeout for some substitutions and a talk by the coaches, as we have a minute 25 seconds left in regulation, and Hopkinton is leading by 11, up 37-26. As the Lancers will head back to their bench, and I think they thought they were just going to go back out there and inbound, but their head coach going to have a word with them. Well, it's been a good, tough, physical, defensive game from both these teams, and these are two teams that have struggled offensively, so coming into this matchup, you certainly had to think that's probably what it would come down to. But the last time these two teams met up back on December 22nd, it was actually one of the most offensive games for both of them of the season. Norton won that game at Norton High School, 64-61. That was just a tough loss to take for the Hillers. But on the good side of things, Hopkinton put up their fourth highest score of the season by racking up 61 points in that game. But that ended up being a tough stretch for the Hillers, where they lost five straight. After that, they lost another heartbreaker to Westboro, 58-57, a game which throughout they led most of. But they are still alive here as a good drive down the right side of the key by Munger. And he puts it up and in for the Lancers. And Coach Keene wants a timeout with 1:16 left. He doesn't want to watch this lead slip away. Hillers 37, Norton 28. You're tuned in to Hopkinton Boys Varsity Basketball on HCAM. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. Let's take a look at the scoring totals. Brandon Kelly with two, Nick Stanley with three, Ben McKenzie for the Hillers has five, Jimmy Adams with three, Austin O'Dell has 10, Zach Sosicki is having a nice night as well. He has eight, Kyle Rector with six for the Norton Lancers. It is Tim Munger with eight, Brett Govin with three, Matt Goodman has six, Matt Peterson with five, Jarrett Sicard with two, McKinley Kearsley with one, and Nick Ruby with three. As the Lancers ready to go, and the official over to the Hopkinton bench to break up this discussion. As we are set for the final 1 minute and 16 seconds of regulation. Norton is going to be aggressive. They're going to be trying to force the turnovers. And more than likely, you're going to see a few fouls in the next 60 seconds or so. Nick Stanley, pass over to McKenzie. They're not going to foul immediately, though. They're going to try to draw the turnover, which is probably the smart thing to do at this point. To Blanchard on the left wing. Trying to drive in, stolen away. Quick break up court. Munger into the lane, up with the right hand, and he will draw the contact. Tim Munger trying to huck up the hook shot, and a great steal and a great job by Munger rushing up the floor. First of two, no. 56 seconds left on the clock now. Second free throw opportunity for Munger. No good. And then knocked out of bounds by Rector. So the Lancers have it back. Well, they need a quick pass and shoot here. You have to score these points rapidly. Up top to Goodman. Over to the corner, out of the hands of Munger. He could not hold on to it. Hillers have it back. Stanley with possession. Over to Adams on the right side of the perimeter. Back to Stanley towards the sideline. Trying to waste the clock, 35 seconds and ticking. Lancers not going to foul just yet. And at this point, they might not at all. McKenzie into the paint, around a couple defenders, wide open path to the basket as he puts it in off the glass with the right hand. Lancers working their way back up the near side. McClear on the right side of the perimeter, over to Sicard in the short corner, driving baseline up for the shot, he'll draw the foul. Rector with a little more of the ball there with just the simple reach up by the 6'11" center. Sicard on the first is no good. Well, free throw shooting has really not helped the Lancers at all tonight. Second opportunity, yes. 39-28, 10 seconds left, and we'll get a timeout here for some reason. And 39-29 is the score, and we'll get a timeout here for whatever reason. Not quite sure what you're going to talk about in this 10 seconds. This game has already been determined. Hopkinton's up by 10. I think it's pretty impossible to put up 10 points in 10 seconds, but you never know, I guess. So they're going to talk things over here, and we will talk about the Hopkinton Hillers, who are getting a well-needed win. They're going to improve to 6-8. You got a tough road ahead. You're going to need to take home 4 of your next 6 games at the very least to get into the postseason. It's not going to be easy. Tough schedule coming up. But if they can get their offense going, they can do it. Jimmy Adams on the entry. He's going to air this one out over to Stanley. Wide open, and the lay-in attempt no good. Norton has it. Buzzer beater here. Can they do it again? They have already had a couple, and they will not have one this time. 39-29. That is going to do it as the Hopkinton Hillers get the victory and maybe a little bit of revenge after a tough loss to the Norton Lancers earlier in this season. But a nice win for Hopkinton. They remain very much in the playoff picture as they defeat the Norton Lancers 39-29. Hopkinton now 6-8 on the season. The Lancers fall to 3-11. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for watching this HCAM production of Hopkinton Hillers boys varsity basketball. The Hopkinton Hillers get the victory over the Norton Lancers tonight at the Hopkinton Middle School Brown Gymnasium. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your night, and we'll talk to you soon.